So what was your favorite movie of the year? Hi everybody, I'm Andy Vineberg, and we're about to talk some Academy Awards. The Oscars are Sunday night, of course, and I'm here at the County Theater in Doylestown, where you can actually come out and watch the Oscars on the big screen this Sunday. And I'm with Ben Skamla, the marketing assistant for the theater, and we're going to kind of go over the awards, who he likes, who he thinks might win, who he thinks maybe should have been nominated, and we'll get right into it with the major categories. Ben, let's start with Best Director. Everybody's saying that this is Guillermo del Toro's year to finally win his first Oscar, of course, The Shape of Water. What do you think, Ben?
Yeah, certainly. I mean, he is the favorite. And it's been, you know, a long time coming. You've seen him sort of hone his craft over the years, and kind of out of nowhere, they got 13 nominations. So it really feels like it's going to be his time. And, you know, of course, you know, fan favorite. And he took a chance. And in a lot of ways, it's sort of his love letter to sort of classic movies. And you have sort of the Creature from the Black Lagoon vibe. And it's just a wonderful mixture of a lot of different genres. So that would be where my money's at. Yeah, I think that's a safe bet.
Okay, well, let's get right into it now with the acting nominations, and we'll start with the supporting categories. And this is a lot of years where you see the surprises in the supporting categories. Of course, we do have two favorites this year, Allison Janney for I, Tonya, and Sam Rockwell for Three Billboards Outside Ebbing, Missouri. What do you think about the supporting categories, Ben?
For as far as Best Supporting Actress goes, I think it might be Laurie Metcalf's moment for her performance playing Saoirse Ronan's mother in Lady Bird, which I know a lot of people liked. And it's great to see you know, actors and actresses who kind of have been out of the spotlight or haven't exactly had a big role get a little more attention. So I think it might be hers to lose. That being said, I think Allison Janney does stand a fair chance of winning it as well for her and I, Tonya.
Right. The thing about Allison Janney and Sam Rockwell for Three Billboards, if they win, it would be, it's the first time they've ever been nominated, so that's kind of cool. Let's move on now to the lead actor and lead actress, and lead actor might be the biggest lock of the night. Gary Oldman for his brilliant portrayal of Winston Churchill in The Darkest Hour. Can anybody beat him this year, Ben?
Well, I mean, he is the favorite right now. It seems like everybody I talk to is putting him down on their Oscar ballot. That Timothy Chalamet really made a splash. I think he's definitely the youngest. I believe he's only 22. I think what you see a lot of the times is someone who's new on the scene like that, and especially in a leading role, maybe not the first couple times around will get it. So I don't know that I'd put my money on him. It does seem like it's Gary Oldman's award to lose.
The one guy who probably won't win, if it is Gary Oldman's award, is Daniel Day-Lewis. And of course, this is, he said this is the last movie he's ever going to do, Phantom Thread. And now if he wins, it would be his fourth, which would tie him with Katharine Hepburn for the most acting Oscars ever. But I think his legacy would be okay, even if he doesn't get that fourth Oscar.
Oh, for sure. It's not like he needs a fourth one. But as you said, it is his last role. So, I mean, I wouldn't be surprised. He is sort of the art house favorite, the sort of method actor who's been around. And it wouldn't shock me to see it go home with him that night.
Okay. Leading actress, we also have a big favorite, Frances McDormand. She was absolutely stunning in Three Billboards. Of course, a lot of people like Saoirse Ronan for Lady Bird. What are your thoughts on Best Actress?
Yeah, I certainly think that the favorite is Frances McDormand. That's who. That's my pick. That's who I'm going with. Someone who, and this, especially in Three Billboards, displays like a really varied performance, a real wide range of emotion, and coming down to even just the nuances, you know, her expression in certain scenes, and then she kind of vacillates between moods. Really, really strong performance. So I think it's hers to lose. Also, Sally Hawkins from The Shape of Water. This really feels like her year. She was in Maudie earlier in the year, and that got a lot of good buzz. So I think it comes down to between the two of them, but I'm going to go with Frances McDormand.
Okay, I think that's a smart choice right there. All right, well, let's get now to Best Picture. And before I ask you who you think is going to win this year, we should point out that Get Out and Dunkirk were really the only big box office hits among this year's Best Picture nominees. Do you think there should be more kind of audience favorites among the Best Picture nominees each year? Or do you think the Academy does a good job of their selections?
I definitely think there's room for both sort of audience favorite and the crowd pleaser versus the sort of highbrow art house movie. Like you said, Dunkirk and Get Out, both of which we ended up playing this year, had this phenomenal wide appeal while also being held in really high esteem. And in the case of Get Out, Jordan Peele using that as a platform to address social issues and everything. So I think it's this fantastic mixture, and I definitely think there's room for art house favorites and things that have a little bit of a wider reach. So I'm very happy to see both of those nominated.
Okay. Now, as far as who will win, the favorites, of course, are Three Billboards and Shape of Water with its 13 nominations. Do you think one of those two brings home the big prize, or do you think is there a dark horse candidate this year?
Absolutely. I'm going to go with Shape of Water on this one, just for the sheer amount of buzz it got. And that is sort of an art house film that has a little bit of a wider reach and kind of blends genres in a way that I think really resonated with people. And Sally Hawkins just knocked it out of the park. And Guillermo del Toro has been around, it feels like forever, and it really feels like his year for this one.
Okay. Any other, I know we were talking earlier, you said you really liked Get Out. Anything else among the best pictures that could maybe sneak in there?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, personally, I'm pulling for Get Out a little bit. That is kind of the long shot this year, I think. But stranger things have happened, and I think as far as that, I would not be disappointed if Get Out was the surprise best picture this year.
Right. As long as they don't pull out the wrong envelope for the best picture this year, that would.
I think they'd probably iron that one out. I wouldn't count on it this year.
Right.
All right. Well, there you have it. That's Ben Skamla, marketing assistant here at the County Theater in Doylestown, talking Academy Awards. And as we said earlier, you can come out and actually watch the Academy Awards right here on this big screen, unlimited popcorn, and hang out with your fellow movie lovers. So from Doylestown, I'm Andy Vineberg.